it sounds like you've been on, you've had these different stages and you've evolved in a way from being very type A and exploring different psychedelics, and each one of them has had a different sort of impact on you. Mm-hmm. You just came out of, or recently came out of, your first ketamine experience with Field Trip. Mm-hmm. Is there something in the back of your mind you're already thinking about, this is next, or you know, next year or 5 years from now?
Oh yeah,
I want to do this. And it could be, I want to do this specific psychedelic, or it could be, I want to revisit mushrooms but accomplish something different.
Right, sure. Well, ayahuasca, I think that actually might become my medicine after trying that. So I will be planning a retreat in 2021. Otherwise, I say I am working on a post that kind of catalogs my journey, because it is pretty crazy to think that it is really like steps that I think could really resonate with people. It starts very high level, like to get from like calm to like psychedelics, like using calm every day to psychedelics, it's just like some very different, a lot of steps needed to happen. And so I'm just starting to write that out. And so I think it starts with understanding yourself and building awareness, mindfulness, meditation, just at like a basic level, just understanding who you are and like having awareness on like the voices in your head, the narratives, like what your patterns are. And the next is losing yourself, letting that go, and understanding that we are not our egos, we're not our thoughts, we're not our feelings even. They're just things, they're just energy. And that is really like the woo-woo side of things that when I was just listening to calm every day, I would not have been on board. But you get to a certain point in the journey, but when that becomes so obvious, but you need to do the steps beforehand. So I think that's important, but that's where I'm at now, is losing myself and letting myself go and letting the ego go and not identifying with it. We need it to get by and to lead product at a super fast growing startup. But it's, I think what I care about is feeling good in this life. And so feeling good without sacrificing output, without sacrificing upside and productivity, is always like the balance with us type A-ers. And I think finding a way to not identify with that gripping ego is a really great way to do that. And so some resources that I found really powerful for me outside of psychedelics are exploring psychoanalytic psychology with Carl Jung and Freud, Piaget, Nietzsche, Joseph Campbell, Jordan Peterson. He stands on a lot of their shoulders. So their work, Carl Jung specifically, he's like my favorite thinker ever, really speak to this really esoteric but in deep mythological collective unconscious synchronicity, like these concepts that are like deep in the human psyche that drive our behavior, that are go back millions of years, that are built into our DNA as human beings, and that really unify us as humans. And we all have there's a lot of underlying structures in the psyche and that drive the way we are and where this ego comes from and why we care about what we care about. Like, why is it so obvious that sunsets are beautiful to everybody? There's just certain things that, like, why do we love the shape of a circle? Why do we love mandalas? Like, the mythology and symbolism in the collective unconscious goes back forever. And it's actually what a lot of religion is based in. And so that's the path I've been going down lately with. I'm a voracious reader, and that's been what's been really interesting and very complementary to psychedelic experiences.